in classes with Amita. As the last time we talked about articoli, determinativi, those that have il, lo, la, etc. This time we're going to talk about articoli indeterminativi, those ones that don't specify something, that don't know someone, right? So, which are those? E or N, which in Italian is uno o una. So, let's see to the masculine part. Masculine singular, the rule are two. Before consonant or vowel, that's one. And then the next one that we saw in the other ones too is before S, yes, consonant, or Z or GN, that means ny, or PS or Y. So, before consonant or vowel, we put un, U-N, un, and before this big rule, S plus consonant, Z, ny, PS or Y, we put uno, U and O. Uno, matlab ki ek. Ehi jada ya, inu keta pa ek Punjabi ch. Bhi ek a cheez hogi ya ek o cheez hogi. So, feminine. Feminine singular. Una. These are the two rules. Is which ehi rule hi hega ki before consonant de s plus consonant or g and ja p s ja y or z oh bada rule hai nahi ho. Ithe the only rule here is before consonant or before vowel. So before consonant there is una, u and a, una, and before vowel again there's apostrophe, so u and apostrophe, un apostrophe. So let's take a look to some examples. So if you look at here, uno, giallo, again I'm gonna kind of use the same examples of the last video. So uno giallo, that means cool. Giallo, it's uno. Why? Because it's before the Z and it's masculine, so Z, so there's a uno. Then una casa, una. Why there's a una? Una, there's a consonant and it's feminine, so before consonant. Un cane, un, it's masculine, and cane, there's a consonant, so there's un instead of uno. If you go back in the video, in this video, you can again check the rules and do your some exercises or check out for new words. So un cane, before consonant and masculine. Un'amica, un apostrophe, as I told you, it's a feminine and there's a vowel, so un'amica, and it's before vowel, feminine. Now let's see the plural ones. So these are called articoli partitivi, partitive articles. I didn't erase this one because it's related to this video. Partitive articles are the plural of the articles indeterminative. So the masculine plural is, there are two rules for this one, which is before consonant there is dei, D-E-I, dei, and before vowel there is or, S plus consonant, Z, P, S, G, N, Y, or X. So before any other rule of vowel or the other consonant, there is dei. So you just have two options. If you do see a word with a consonant as un cane, C, C-A-N-E, cane is spelled C-A-N-E, and the C is a consonant, so you put dei cani. Instead, if you see a vowel in before a word, before something, anything else, if you see a vowel or all of these rules, you put simply degli, D-E-G-L-I, degli. Now let's see the feminine part. Feminine part is super easy. That means there's only one word, one article. Any, there can be with a vowel, vowel or consonant or that vowel, any, if there's a plural, you just put delle, delle, amiche, delle, case, delle, mamme, etc, etc. So, now, let's see again the example. So, here's the example of the plural. So, plural is degli zaini. Why degli? Again, as I told you, degli zaini, because there's a Z. Then, una casa becomes delle case, because the only plural in feminine, again, is only delle. Then, dei cani, because it's a consonant. And again, delle, because it's feminine. So, this is all for today's video, and I hope this helped you a lot. And if it didn't, please let me know what could I improve. And we'll meet in the next video. Bye-bye.